There are 34 million people infected with HIV/AIDS today. Of these, 22 million live in sub-Saharan Africa. And 60% of these people are women, and only 40% are men. I'm interested in two things. Why is HIV/AIDS most concentrated in sub-Saharan Africa? And why are women disproportionately affected by AIDS? To eradicate the AIDS epidemic in sub-Saharan Africa, we need to consider a more complex policy than just educating men and women about condom use. We need to consider the social organization of African countries around ethnic groups. While in a society organized around ethnic groups, which means that members of the same group meet frequently to share information, people will tend to choose their partners from different ethnic groups to hide their infidelity. This is because choosing partners in different ethnic groups maximizes the social distance between those partners, and so they do not have any chance to meet to share information about their common lover. Ethnic heterogeneity then has two effects. The first, it increases sexual infidelity, and second, it leads to large sexual networks that interconnect several ethnic groups, which in turn spread HIV/AIDS widely. What stands out as really surprising in my research is that I found that more educated men and women are more likely to be infected by HIV/AIDS, which is really counterintuitive given the policy of organization to stress education as a way to eradicate the AIDS virus. In fact, more educated men and women are more desirable as partners because of their social status. So they attract more partners and they find themselves in large sexual networks, which make them more vulnerable to HIV/AIDS. First, we need to reduce gender inequality to increase the rights of women, which will lead to more egalitarian sexual networks where men and women have the same number of sexual partners. Second, we need to increase ethnic integration because that will reduce the incentive of people to diversify their partners along ethnic lines to hide their infidelity. And third, we need to encourage social and regional integration by developing different regions of a country more evenly. That will reduce the rate of migration to more prosperous region. The same tactics lead to the same result. But HIV/AIDS is a more complex disease that basically spreads through sexual networks. And so I invite the academic community and the not-for-profit organization interested in the issue of HIV/AIDS to consider alternative approach. I believe that the theory of fidelity network provides insight into policy that could be implemented to eradicate the disease.